When everyone in your family has different schedules and activities, it can be difficult to manage the day-to-day events inside of your family. Notion can be a wonderful tool for managing your family, and in this video, we wanted to give you a Notion tour and tutorial of our family planner and organizer. This template features everything from family calendars, allergy lists, important documents, photo galleries, and more. If you find this video useful, be sure to like, subscribe, and turn on the notification bell. So when you first open up this family organizer and planner, you'll notice the following sections. So in the main dashboard, you can see your today, tomorrow, and each of these are going to be shown by person. So you can also track who has what every day. And you can also mark things as done if it's something that you need to keep track of that way as well. The full family calendar is going to appear here, and those are also going to be related to the items that are up top, but you can have a monthly and a weekly view. Over on our left side, you'll have your quick links here with all the links to each database included in this template, as well as a quick view of your contacts. So this can be really useful if you want to see only your emergency contacts, as that can be one of the most important contacts to have. So to get started with this template, we would highly recommend you to first start with our family. So we're going to go ahead and click our family. So it's really important to add each of your family members here first so that you can actually tag them in. So first, for example, if you want to just use the pre-included three family members, you can click one open and then edit the picture, change cover photo, and you can upload a photo. You can add the name, the birthday, and then what you can also do is to now see your calendar specific to that person and important documents, medications, allergies, and a photo gallery. And the same applies to each of your family members. If you want to start one from scratch, you can simply click plus new in here to add a new family member. So let's say we have a new family member here, and you can add their birthday. So we can go ahead and add that here. So let's say something like this, and then you can have their name, sample name. And if you'd like to customize this, you can add even more properties here. So if you click plus add a property, you can see that there are many things you can add here, even like favorite foods, gifts, colors, something fun if you want to do that. You can also add relationship and so on. So there's a lot you can add in the add a property. And again, just like all the others, if you scroll down, you can see the calendar views here. And you can see the important documents, medications, allergies, intolerances, and the photo gallery. And make sure to add a cover photo by clicking add cover, change cover, and then upload the picture of the family member. So now if we go back to the main dashboard, we can go to the next section. So the next section we wanted to really show is the family calendar. So if we go ahead and open this one up, you can start to see a month view and a weekly view. So this place is really useful if you need to keep track of things like lessons or picking up from school and other kinds of school events and who's doing what at what time. So let's say that we know for sure that your new added family member, let's say on Friday here, has a school pickup. So you need to pick up this family member from school. You can go ahead and click the type. So this one is a pickup, and you can add who. So if this is, let's say the sample name is actually your son or daughter, and name one here was mom or dad, you can put both of these names here, as well as some notes like the location and so on. And then if we click out, you can see here like this. So it's easy to see who it is and what kind of thing it is and whether or not it's done. If you want to add a time to this, you can also click here and include time. So let's say that this is at 6 p.m. You can put something like this and then click out. And one thing that's interesting is if you put it, for example, to today and we go back, you can now see here your today schedule. So today at 6 p.m. is this school pickup, and you can add notes and then whether or not it's done. And then if we go to today by person, you can see everyone's schedule in this kind of board view. So you can easily see school pickup for this person here at 6 p.m. So this way you can really see each schedule really clearly. And you can also do things, for example, like if this is the day you need to pay for your piano lessons for your child, you can also do something like that. So if this is a payment, you can do that, and then you can put who it is. So something like this, and some notes. So like this, you can really schedule your days and see exactly what's coming up. So you can also see tomorrow. So if this was happening tomorrow, you can also see that here, like this. And if you want to actually see this in Notion Calendar, you can also click Open in Calendar to use Notion Calendar, which allows you to also see your Google Calendar in the same place. The next thing we wanted to show you is the important contacts. So we're going to go ahead and click Important Contacts. So important contacts, you can add everyone important to your family. This can be things like emergency numbers, doctors, teachers, and so on. So let's say that we're going to add a teacher here. You can add 5th grade teacher, and you can add the type. So let's say that this is a teacher, and a description, a phone number, address, email, and URL. So this way you can really see like this and keep track of everyone's contacts. So if we go by type, you can see emergency, teacher, and so on. And we have extra tabs for emergency and doctors, just so that you can see those as well and easily organize your family's contact lists. If you want to kind of customize this contact database, you can also click the plus sign here to add additional properties as needed. If there are some small things you want to add, like relationships, preferred contact method, and so on. But this is a really great base for your contact list. If you add someone as an emergency, it's going to automatically add it here so that you can always see your emergency contacts. The next section we wanted to show you is the family documents. In family documents, you can add things like identification and for who, and the notes and a file and media, which could include anything like PDFs and photos. So if you want to add something here, you can add that. So for example, driver's license, and then you can put the type, which could be identification. And you can put for who, so you can add the person here, notes and files and media. This can also be things like achievement, certificate, and then you can do something like this. You can also add grade reports, and you can do a name here and so on. If you want to add a new option, you can also add them through here. So all you have to do is add a new option and then click create. So here we'll add achievement certificates. Then if we go to person, you can see each person's documents. So it's really easy to keep track of it. You can also see them by type. So you can see everyone's identifications. You can see all the achievement certificates and so on. If we go back to the family organizer main dashboard, the next thing we wanted to show is the allergies and intolerances. And here you can list everyone's allergies and intolerances so that you can actually share this page to anyone who's cooking for your family or to your school teachers and so on. So here we have, for example, allergy 2, and let's say that this sample name here is allergic to this, and then your notes, and then you can add a severity as well. So if this is a really severe allergy and this is severe, use an EpiPen, for example. And then what you can do is if you go to by person, you can see also this allergy list here. And if we want to share this entire list, you can go ahead and click share. And we could recommend you to just publish this page so that you can actually just share it as a web page, which makes it really easy to send to your teachers or to restaurants and so on. So now we're going to go back to our main page. The next thing we wanted to show you is the medication list. So this is also really useful so that you can see exactly what's needed. So you have your current medications, for who, how often, expiration date, prescription, and notes and files and media. So here you can also see all of your expired medications, and this way you can remember to actually renew them as well. And for example, by how often, you can keep track. If it's something is daily, you can see all the medications that need to be administered daily. You can also see by person and so on. So if we go ahead and click one here, and let's say that the expiration date is And you can add how often, is it as needed, every day, twice a day, and so on. Is there a prescription for it? And all of these items, and it's going to also show up inside of your family member. So now if we go back to the family organizer dashboard, let's go over to family photo gallery. So this is a really fun space for your family to collect your memories. So here you can basically view all of all the photos. If you want to add a new photo, you can click plus new. So let's say that you had a day in the mountains, and you can put a date and then tags. So is this a vacation photo? Who is in the photo? So you can add all of your family members, whoever's in there. And then you can add the picture here as a cover photo, change cover, unsplash. And then let's say that we have a mountain. And then if we click out, we see the mountain picture. You can also add some additional text here if you want to kind of journal about it as well. And this way you can see by tag, like this is a family photo, this is a vacation photo. You can view by person to see who's in which picture. You can also see by month. So this way you can also enjoy what happened each month as well. So this is a really fun space to collect your photos. If we go back to the main dashboard, the next section we wanted to show you is the babysitter notebook. So this is obviously for those who have really young kids that you need to actually show your babysitter certain information and guidelines on how to babysit. So let's say that we have this page babysitting while we go out of town, and then you have a duration here, and then you can add a babysitter, someone named Jane Smith. And then what you can do is to open it up and you can see emergency contacts, house rules, what to do in an emergency, meals, suggested activities, bedtimes, notes. You can add your children's age, medications, and so on here. And when you're done with this, you can actually click the share button and share it as a web page. So you can go ahead and click share. And then if you publish this, you can easily share this. So this is a really great way to share your information to your babysitters in a really easy way. If we click this closed, you can also edit the main content of this database template by going to the three dots here, edit. And if, for example, you always have the same house rules, you always have this emergency information, be sure to change it inside of this template so that every time you load a new notebook for the babysitter, it's going to be the same information. So let's say that you have a house rule, not allowed to eat junk food, then you can click out. And then every time you add a new one here and you open it up, it's going to show these house rules. So if you have multiple types of babysitters, this can also help you save time so that you always have your house rules, emergency information, specific meals that you need to have for that babysitter as well, suggested activities, and so on. So be sure to customize this as needed depending on your needs. If you don't need the babysitter notebook, you can also opt not to use it. So this is entirely optional. If we go ahead and go back here, we can now go back to our family. And since we added many things to the sample name here, we can go ahead and open this up. And now you'll see that every time this person is tagged in anything from calendar, important documents, medications, allergies, and gallery photos, you can always see them inside here. So this makes it really interconnected and easy to use. You can also add specific documents, medications, allergies, and so on directly through each person as well, if that's the way that you'd like to do it. So there's multiple ways to use this template. Thank you so much for watching. If you're interested in this template, we'll leave the link to it in the description below. Feel free to let us know if you have any questions or comments, and we hope to see you all in the next video.